The QT2 device does have a setting button. It is in the form of a wrench. You're going to be able to press that and use the directional pad to navigate around. When you're ready to make a selection, you're either going to press the OK function button or the center button of the directional pad. The first setting that we have is a hand raised. Below it, it indicates what that setting is. So this is send message, and you're going to press the directional pad, the center button. It's going to take you into the message. From here, you're going to be able to type a message to the presenter. Verify that the information is correct on the LCD screen, and then when you're ready to send it, press the OK button, and it sends it in, verifying with a check mark indicating the message has been sent, and then pressing the back arrow on the function bar to take you out. Your ID, so this is where you're going to be able to have your participant sign into your device. So this way you can set a specific device for a specific individual. Type in their name, and then press the OK button. Now this device is assigned to David Curl. Press the back arrow button to exit out. The last option is the settings. So this is where you're going to be able to view your device information. So it's going to display that device ID. This is the same ID that is on the back of your response card. You're also going to be able to adjust the contrasts, the brightness. The back function key takes you out of the settings. If you ever get lost in the menu, pressing the back function key button a few times will eventually take you back to the question screen. From here, you're just going to be able to answer questions as they appear.